many good nights spent there.
Well, let's let others take a trip down memory lane with us, if you will. The numbers to call are 1-800-565-1940, 1-800-565-1940. That's toll-free anywhere in the Maritimes. Or in Halifax, you can call us at 420-9336, 420-9336. We're talking about music from the 80s, trying to find the definitive act or performer. From the 80s. Let's go to David Johnson in Truro, Nova Scotia. Hi, David.
Hi, good afternoon. How are you?
I'm great.
Fantastic, and I must say thank you, thank you, thank you for having this show, celebrating one of the most colorful, creative decades ever. The hosts you've got, the enthusiasm, their shows on the radio themselves, fantastic. I'm just getting all kinds of those warm, fuzzy velvet memories just listening to y'all.
All right, so what do you think was the definitive act or band?
Well, just as a very quick follow-up to what you folks were discussing, certainly the video age begins in the 80s, you know, en masse, and I'm sure your hosts know about this. Perhaps it might be news to our listeners. The Video Killed the Radio Star from the Buggles was the first video aired on MTV when that launched, I believe, in 1981. Correct me if I'm wrong. So that was rather an emblem of the decade to come. The fact that now the look of a band, as your hosts were saying, were now the look was more important, or at least certainly as important as what they were singing in the first place. A very transitional thing. So when you say, what is the definitive 80s band? Well, of course, lots of people have memories watching CBC Switchback on Sunday morning, mm-hmm. Good Rockin' Tonight, Video Hits.
Yeah.
We had those countdown-like shows. If you're using record sales as criteria, obviously Thriller, the Michael mm-hmm. Jackson Thriller. That's for simple sales phenomenon, there's no question. However, if you're talking about a personal favorite, I mean, everybody, your listeners are going to have Duran Duran. I enjoy all the ones your hosts have mentioned, Police, including Pet Shop Boys. But if you want to just use the word definitive, I'm almost trying to narrow the criteria down to a band that was big, huge in the 80s, like a Supernova, and then did nothing afterwards. Almost a band that is emblematic of the 80s, like the way Max Headroom is. He was big in the 80s, but he did not make a comeback at any other time. You think of Max Headroom, you think 80s. So to take the long way home, paraphrase Supertramp here, to get to your answer, I nominate Huey Lewis and the News.
They
were huge with their sports album, with the 4 album, with the Power of Love in 85, right in the center of that great decade. But after that, they really didn't do much in the 90s, and I haven't heard anything from them since. They, ironically, were an 80s band that was somewhat nostalgic for the 50s. They had that old-fashioned rock and roll sound, almost like a Happy Days type of band, and a lot of great number one hits. But unlike Duran Duran, who have obviously resurrected themselves and have another great album out, the Police who've reunited, you know, Prince and Bowie who evolve and sort of span the decades, like Elton John and Madonna, Huey Lewis was pretty well in the 80s, and that was it. And that's why I nominate them for the definitive 80s band.
All right.
I think that's a good choice, actually. I think Huey Lewis was doing a Broadway show there a couple of years ago. I think I read something about him being on Broadway in New York.
Yes, he's done movies as well. And he's more of an actor these days.
Wow. The heart of rock and roll keeps beating.
True enough. Thanks for calling, David.
Cool. Thank you.
All right. Bye-bye.